Take a look at today's Hong Kong streets, and you're likely to sense that something's amiss. Neon. Hong Kong's nightscape has long been synonymous with the numerous neon signs that graced its streets. Or at least that was the case until recently. Why is Hong Kong's streetscape changing? And who are the people keen to preserve Hong Kong's visual heritage? In 2022, the demolition of the iconic Kum Nau Wa bridal shop signboard in Kowloon renewed interest in retaining them. As other neon signs face a similar fate, people have been flocking to capture their final glimmer. Suki and Keith are among the many who came to photograph Tai Tung Bakery in Yuen Long after the owner announced its sign would be taken down. The bakery received a removal order in 2022 from Hong Kong's buildings department after the signboard was first declared a safety hazard the previous year. The third-generation owner of the 80-year-old bakery says he was overwhelmed by the public's response.
係啊，有好多人走嚟懷念，因為香港啲招牌已經拆到所剩無幾㗎啦。同你睇翻70年代嘅彌敦道啊，甚至有好多街咧嘅招牌咧已經係少之又少㗎啦。咁我哋都好感動啊！我覺得香港人係即係佢哋對於文化嘅保留，比以前係。 係進步咗好多，因為藝虹光管係佢放嗰個光出嚟咧，係有立體感嘅。如果你而家用 LED 或者用嗰啲類似投射機啊，佢就冇藝虹光管咧嗰種咧嗰啲光咧有少少震盪，有少少跳動咧嗰種感覺出嚟嘅。咁所以藝虹光管呢樣嘢，我哋特別有感情。 你話如果我做一個膠箱，成個膠箱嘅招牌喺度，咁嗰個特色就冇咗啦，同埋大家行過，你唔會覺得佢係啲乜嘢，冇啊，即係普通廣告牌啫嘛，咁嘅樣係啦。
If Hong Kong people hold such a strong attachment to neon signs, why are they being phased out, and where do they end up? This is where the more fortunate neon signs are retired.
5:30出到街度去接呢個招牌，其實佢喺現址上面其實已經屹立咗有4-50年呢樣。咁我睇翻佢哋啲舊相咧，咁其實嗰個設計真係一模，仲係同當時一模一樣。咁所以其實你可以諗下喺銅鑼灣有一個潮州呢一個酒家嘅招牌，喺一啲好現代化嘅地區入邊或者條街入邊，仲可以見到呢個招牌，其實係一個係佢哋。
Cardin Chan runs a non-profit group that aims to preserve Hong Kong's neon sign culture.
香港仲剩翻，但冇可能原址保留到嘅霓虹招牌。我哋希望盡我哋所能能力去保留翻佢哋先，等佢唔好抌咗去堆填區或者當佢冷鐵咁樣俾人買咗。
Its collection of discarded neon signboards includes those from the Kum Nau Wa bridal shop.
咁譬如就觀南馬啦，其實我哋觀南馬有兩個招牌，即係好好彩，經過一年嘅商討，同埋最後尾我哋亦都揾到一啲即係最新嘅資料，可以話到俾商户聽，得到佢哋嘅信任，而佢哋捐咗嘅招牌俾我哋，係屬於樓宇嘅一部分，咁佢就會屬。 屬於個監管嘅範圍之內，咁跟住之後，其實佢有好多無論尺寸啊，無論物料啊，無論安裝嘅方法，其實都有好清楚嘅規定嘅。咁所以其實好多現行嘅呢啲咁嘅霓虹招牌或者招牌咧，其實好多都唔合佢而家現時呢個法例㗎啦。咁所以其實佢哋都會覺得係應該需要取締嘅。
The heyday of neon signage in Hong Kong was in the 1970s and 80s, when there were few regulations for these structures. The sign makers were largely free to be creative. But as the signs age, concerns have grown about the safety of the hanging constructions. In 2003, the government began issuing removal orders for signs inconsistent with modern safety standards and set up a dedicated system to regulate signboards in 2010. The tightened rules meant all signs erected before 2010 are retrospectively declared illegal, and authorities have been gradually enforcing removal orders. Miles Yun is among the many who started sharing photographs of neon signs on Instagram.
我覺得霓虹招牌代表緊即係香港東方之珠呢個街頭文化啦，因為譬如以前電影啊，好多時外國啲人過嚟拍都會拍到啊香港有一個招牌海，好多霓虹燈。咁會覺得係街頭甚至一個藝術文化嘅視覺文化嘅一種咁樣咯。社區即係同街坊傾偈可以俾翻我一個動力啦，或者係特別係之前即係社運嗰段時間，或者其實依家都係充斥住一種即係可能好負面嘅情緒。
The buildings department says it does not target neon signs and does not differentiate them from other non-glowing old signs, with an average of about 3,300 signboards that have been removed or replaced between 2018 and 2022.
傳統嚟講，好多呢啲招牌，好多呢啲商户都會覺得呢啲招牌同佢哋嘅生意係合，係佢靈魂所在，合二為一嘅。當佢好多時候，佢哋好唔想俾人知道，或者好唔想俾人見到，就係俾人拆招牌呢一樣嘢。佢會覺得，如果連個招牌都冇咗，好多時候分分鐘令到佢都會覺得我唔想再做我生意。其實好多仲有人招牌嘅地方，都係啲舊區或者一啲屬於啲舊樓上。
咁但係當呢啲咁嘅城市發展嘅時候，令到呢啲舊區要重建啊，咁佢哋呢啲咁嘅佢哋自然嘅生態環境都被摧毀嘅時候，咁霓虹招牌自然都會消失。咁嗰陣時就會覺得啊，我嘅記錄係有意思，因為會覺得有啲即係招牌嘅保育團體見到即係有特色嘅招牌，都會叫我問下老闆可唔可以幫手去睇下啊，佢哋願唔願意去。
Some shop owners have put up new neon signs that conform with current standards when their old ones were removed. But not everyone believes it's worth the expense, since new technologies like LED screens offer a more cost-effective alternative.
譬如你可以見到喺銅鑼灣某大百貨公司、某大街口嗰度，你會見到係不斷轉畫，或者喺中環亦都會見到嘅。咁其實嗰啲就係可以可能唔同嘅廣告商都可以落到廣告，咁亦都切合翻而家嘅經濟嘅效益啊、經濟嘅需要。咁呢啲都係取替緊嚟。我哋希望大家都會繼續持續去留意翻，其實特別係而家香港已經唔係剩翻好多龍招牌，唔好等到最。
最後嘅十大，你先至會話我哋去懷緬下究竟係點樣，而係真係趁佢哋而家仲有幾百個喺度剩翻嘅時候，就大家都諗下。近排拆招牌咧，其實係多咗人關注，多咗人去認啦。但係因為頭先有講到啊，其實去整一個招牌，或者去即係維修一個招牌都有成本嘅考慮啦。咁所以如果可能大家認知如再，可能行多一步係可能幫襯多啲老店啊、小店嘅話咧。 其實都可能有機會係幫助到個鋪頭去多啲經費去維修啊，或者去鞏固啊，或者去做一個新嘅招牌。